Tesla was able to transmute energy, broadcast energy in a wireless capacity, and he was able to extract that energy, free energy from the sun and the stars. So that's just the tip of the iceberg here, where we're going with this energy.
Are you curious about discovering ways of making your life better? Then welcome to my podcast. I'm Bob Nickman, and this is The Exploding Human. Listen in while I talk with all kinds of people in the fields of personal growth, health and healing, alternative therapies, psychology, spirituality, environment, and the future. I'm looking for those answers that make life better for everyone. You'll meet cutting-edge practitioners, doctors, artists, filmmakers, business people, and those who have overcome challenges. The brave, the curious, anyone who's out there helping us humans to explore, expand, and explode.
Hey, welcome to The Exploding Human. My name is Bob Nickman. My guest today is Tom Paladino, and we are going to be talking about the healing power of scalar light, what it is, and how it works. But first, I'd like to invite you to visit my website, theexplodinghuman.com. Over there, you can listen to episodes, read synopses, see photos of my guests. There's a little bio on myself. There's also a YouTube channel where you can listen. That is The Exploding Human with Bob Nickman. As I said, my guest today is Tom Paladino. He works with something called scalar light. Nikola Tesla referred to it as radiant energy, the energy of the universe. I must say this is a very different type of approach to health and healing that I did have some trouble wrapping my head around. Certainly I've had experiences in the benefits of tapping into the non-physical world, meditation being the most obvious one of those. But Tom has taken the work of Nikola Tesla and as a researcher has come up with a device, an instrument to harness scalar light. And he's going to explain how that works and how he has helped 500,000 people. And we're going to be talking about how you can participate in that through his website, scalarlight.com. I'm going to let Tom explain it because he can do it a lot better than me. That's why he's the guest and I'm not. So here he is. This is Tom Paladino.
Good morning, Tom. I'm so glad you're on the show. Oh, I know what I was going to ask you before. You know, we were talking before we started. Where are you? Where are you located?
I live in Florida. I live in Bradenton, Florida.
I have been to Bradenton, Florida. I know exactly where it is. I have been there. Yeah. And my favorite thing down there, those giant bugs that look like roaches. What are they called? What are they called down there? The palmetto bugs.
Okay.
You know what I'm talking about?
Yes, I do.
Yeah. Don't let that stop you from going to Bradenton. No, it's actually a very beautiful place.
Yeah, but besides that minor inconvenience, the west coast of Florida is an ideal place to live.
Yes. Yeah. I was in Sarasota quite a bit, so I know the area. So it's a beautiful place. Yeah, I agree. And I'm glad you're there and there's plenty of light, which segues into our topic of scalar light today. And I was saying before we started, and I don't know if you know that this idea that the sun is some evil thing that's out to hurt us. That's, you know, sunscreen and protection and all this stuff. It never made sense to me because we're born onto the planet and there's a sun and I feel better when I go out in the sun. Now, I don't lay there for, you know, 3 hours and burn my skin. I mean, that just seems kind of foolish and the body will tell you get up. But let's just talk about the sun, what it does, how what scalar light is, all these cool things that you've been researching for quite a while now.
Well, we're going to speak about sunlight and starlight, as you've mentioned, but it's not electricity. I don't work with electricity. I work with another dimension of energy. So there's two dimensions of energy. Electromagnetic, which we've understood is a valid energy, and we can work with it. And we've developed instrumentation that can control electromagnetic energy. There's another energy, scalar energy, what some people call zero point energy. That's what I work with. And why do I work with the other dimension, the other energy? It has a great deal of promise. It's that simple. The technology to be derived from this other source of energy is just outstanding what we can do with it. Its potential as a technology far outweighs that of electricity. So in the future, later in our lifetimes, Bob, you and I are going to see the advent of scalar energy, and this technology will far outpace what we've learned and what we've been able to accomplish with electricity.
It does not surprise me, because I know that you have been a student of Tesla's work.
Yes.
And when we say Tesla, we're not talking about the car company, folks. We're talking about the actual guy, Nikola Tesla, who dealt a lot with electricity, but he also talked about something called, I guess, free energy and the Earth's energy and the sun and all those things. And maybe let's talk about how, you know, what the beginnings were of people realizing there is other energy that we can't see besides electricity.
Tesla was the first man to harness scalar energy. And he really had two careers. If you look closely, he had a career with wires, AC electricity. And then his second career later in his life was wireless energy with scalar energy. So Tesla was the first man to develop this wireless communication system, scalar energy. And again, this is free energy from the sun and the stars. And we should have embraced this technology. Tesla was able to transmute energy, broadcast energy in a wireless capacity, and he was able to extract that energy, free energy from the sun and the stars. So that's just the tip of the iceberg here, where we're going with this energy.
And the idea of it being all around us and in us and everywhere is, a concept I think a lot of people can't grasp sometimes. You know, it's like there's this idea that a lot of people have, if I can't see it and touch it, it's not there. Except you feel it. You feel it every day. Even when you walk outside, you feel better inside or when you go outside. I actually feel better outside. Something happens. Yeah. Just on a physical level, I feel, well, I guess energized would be the word. I feel better.
And to some extent or not, we all do. And that's why you want to get back to nature. Now, what's my point? If I'm working with these forces of nature, these primal forces, then nothing can go wrong. Why? Because the sun and the stars have been with us since the creation of the universe. So there's no adverse effect working with scalar energy. Nobody has an allergic reaction. Nobody has an adverse effect to this type of energy. It's sunlight or starlight in its pure form, in its immaculate form. And with that, there's no pollution. There's no chemical shock. There's no chemical detox. It's not a chemical reaction. It's pure energy, light. And there's no electrons or protons involved with this type of energy. And this is what Nikola Tesla saw, the ability to work with this very quintessence. He called it radiant energy, and he believed that it was non-physical. He described this as a non-physical science. He's right. So we're going to leave behind the world of pollution. We're going to leave behind this slow system of electricity, this dangerous system of electricity, and we're going to go into another system, scalar energy, that is non-physical. It's instructional, it's informational, and there's no downside. There's no pollution, there's no carbon footprint. It's free energy from the sun and the stars.
So do you think, because I've heard this and it makes a lot of sense, that I don't want to spend a lot of time on this part, that corporate profits have stood in the way of this technology?
Yes.
Okay.
A million times yes. Now, go back quickly to Tesla. Tesla demonstrated free energy instruments. He was able to power a car with sunlight, starlight, a scalar energy car. Tesla was able to illuminate light bulbs with scalar energy without wires. Well, why aren't we doing that today? Well, that's a good question. I work alone. I'm a researcher. I'm a scalar energy researcher. I have developed instruments, and I do not include big business with my work. And one of the reasons is because I want to keep this pure technological advancement. I don't want money or politics or power to get in the middle of this equation. So we overcome that by being pure. and by just keeping to the mission.
Well, that's beautiful, because what's going to happen is, the way I sort of see it is, from you, and I don't know if there's other people doing what you're doing. I assume there must be, because it's a big planet, that those people such as yourself will start to, and, you know, I like to think I'm going to be part of that already just by having you on the show, is that information and that technology is going to get to the people that are open-minded enough and willing to experimental to see, oh, this actually works, or this doesn't work, whatever they, you know, decide. But it's going to start at that grassroots level and work its way up rather than from the top down. And that, I think that's where change is always the best thing, when, you know, the people who I'm going to say this, aren't afraid to go for it.
Thank you so much. And that's my approach. It's the bottom up. It's a grassroots approach. Now, if you work with people, people are honorable. I have a grassroots movement, and I love working with the people. And there's no shenanigans, Bob. There's no nonsense here. People want to help. People are good. And, you know, you eliminate corruption. You eliminate bribery. You eliminate people who are just simply greedy for money and power. When you work with the people are good people. They're honorable people. And you're assured success, because nothing can stop a grassroots movement.
Well, you can't stop people that have nothing to lose, because they're not trying to gain anything. So they really don't have anything to lose. Yes. In terms of, you know, it's just when you go in the, you know, you try to go up against courage, you're going to lose in terms of trying to stop it, because there's nothing more powerful than somebody that has a mission and doesn't care and can't be bought. Doesn't care about, you know, the big stuff. Yeah. That it's a, you know, and I love that you're doing that. You know, that is, I'll just say this, it's spiritual work. That's what how I see all this kind of stuff. It's just it's people that want the best for the most people. And boy, is that the antithesis of what a lot of our society has become. So congrats.
Thank you. And that's, you know, in many ways, I'm a Christian, and I've learned the golden rule, obviously. But you look at men like Tesla. Tesla only wanted what was going to advance society. He died penniless. Tesla could have enriched himself along the way. He wasn't interested in that. He was a true scientist. And frankly, I don't know anybody who can hold a candle to him as a prolific inventor that he was. And why did God give him such wisdom? Because he did God's will. Tesla was not using this wisdom for his benefit. He wanted to advance mankind, humanity.
I've read several books on him, and there's some pretty decent documentaries now that are out about Tesla. If you folks who are listening are not familiar with him, I mean, everyone's heard the name, but you know, take a couple hours and spend some time learning about this guy. It's a really fascinating story, that particularly his childhood with some of the illnesses that he had. And I think that almost seemed to me like, when I was reading it, it was some kind of a, I don't know what you would call it, almost like a test that the universe was going to put him through some very difficult things. And he, whatever he sort of drew on inside of himself, and some of those things that happened opened up parts of his brain that the rest of us haven't been able to open yet, that he became this incredible genius. I mean, obviously he had some personal issues with how would you call it, socialization.
Yeah.
Thank God.
Yeah, he was peculiar. There's only one Tesla. So what's the point of my research? In a nutshell, I'm continuing on with the work of Tesla and another inventor by the name of Hieronymus. Both men developed free energy instruments. These instruments are profound in their capability, in their work output, in their potential to do good, to help mankind. And it's been my life path now to introduce this energy, scalar energy, free energy, what some people call zero point energy, to the world. And it's amazing what I've come up against. You think something that would be that would be so helpful, so beneficial to the world, that this would be embraced. Well, it's embraced on a grassroots level, but those organizations that should be helping me are not. And the reason that my work is suppressed is purely for money and power. Free energy is not going to be embraced by all organizations.
Yeah, that makes a lot of sense. I mean, it's, you know, when you disrupt people's income or potential income or belief systems, let's put it that way too, there's a lot of fear that gets generated and people become aggressive and, you know, they're cornered animals when that happens. You know, yes. There's something about human nature. I'm not saying, well, I don't know if, you know, well, we don't want to get into necessarily what human nature is, but many humans are very, very threatened by anything that is a new concept. Yeah. I mean, you look at people through history that have really tried to do certain things and boy, they get attacked constantly.
So. Yeah, it's a shame because if people don't understand something, then some people react in fear. My instruments are quite unique because I'm working in the quantum plane. It's not an electromagnetic plane. And in so doing, I can work with force fields, including force fields on a photograph. Mm-hmm. When I work with my instruments, I only work with photographs of people and animals. My photograph has an energy field or a force field attached to it. And that force field is identical to my force field. So people do not have to visit my laboratory. In substitution, they send their photograph, which represents their force field, or it's essentially their bilocated version. Now, that in and of itself speaks of a new science. Some people call that quantum entanglement. Some people call that the bilocated version of a person. But if we can have a conversation now through Zoom, and we can share this information through light waves, electromagnetic energy, then likewise, I can have a scalar energy session through a person's photograph, through light waves, through scalar light waves. And this is what's unique about my work. I've developed that instrumentation that works with scalar energy, the scalar dimension, and I work with people by way of their photograph.
And what are most of the people, well, what are some of the reasons people come to speak with you and work with you and maybe give a little bit about how you do that?
Yeah. The
as much as you, you know, if there's things you don't want to.
No, I want to divulge everything.
Great. Okay. I was going to say, is there some, you know, instrument that you are working on a patent or something like that, or you're not doing any of that kind of stuff, apparently.
I don't want to patent anything. I actually want to be like Tesla and give it away to the world.
Yay.
And I think the best way to do that is just by offering. I offer free sessions to people. Oh. So my point being is this, a scalar energy instrument can send energy anywhere in the world to any person or any animal or any plant by way of a photograph. My instrument is so powerful and is so exact, I could work with 1 million photographs a day and send energy to 1 million people by way of their force field.
Mm-hmm.
So one scalar energy instrument can easily work with a nation in a short period of time, a country in a short period of time. Now, what are the benefits of working with photographs? I've discovered that everybody has brain waves that are scalar waves that are attached to a photograph. So when I work through a person's photograph, I can balance their brain waves. I can balance their 7 chakras. And I can prove that at least in a subjective fashion, because people tell me after I work with their photograph that they have a sense of mental calm. They're not so anxious or they don't have the depression that they once had. Others will say that the chakra balancing that I will broadcast, that I will administer, serves to remove a phobia or an addiction. Now, I do that again through a photograph of a person. So this is non-physical energy, scalar light, working through a person's force field that produces a sense of calm, of tranquility. Some people have even said they've been able to give up drinking or recreational drugs because this energy is corrective. It's instructional. So that's just the tip of the iceberg, what you can do with a scalar energy instrument.
Well, my first reaction as a civilian, I like that word, civilian, is it sounds too magical for me to trust. That's my first reaction. Now, I'm not saying that's not my second reaction. My second reaction is I want to know more.
Yeah.
And the other part is there's a million people that you could work with. Why hasn't the world been transformed completely by what you're talking about?
You're right. I'll address those concerns and questions. I'm an open book. I want the world to come to us. This is why we give away 15 days of free sessions. Why doesn't the world quite realize this? Well, this technique has never been perfected by anybody else. The instruments that I work with are custom built, hence my achievement is unique. I don't have any peers. There's nobody else. There is no other Tom with a scalar energy instrument. Now, are the results incredible? Yes. But you have to realize that this is not the electromagnetic spectrum. It's the quantum spectrum. And what you and I are akin to, what we're familiar with by way of this dimension that we live in, the electromagnetic dimension, the scalar energy dimension is different. It's not a chemical environment. It's an instructional environment. So we leave behind physicality. We leave behind physical impediments. When you're working exclusively with non-physical science, informational science, you can achieve what you want to achieve in an instant. We don't rely upon a metabolic process or a chemical reaction. There's no chemical reaction with scalar light. It's non-physical. So we send instructions instead of sending a chemical or relying upon a chemical.
Okay, that I completely get. Can you do that? Or no, let me put it this way. Why can't you do that with the entire planet?
I can, if people were to send me photographs.
Okay, so you need a direct
yes.
Interest, let's put it that way.
Yes.
A willingness to go help.
That's right.
Without that, you can't just blanket the planet with wonderfulness.
Correct. The instrument works when it can identify a force field, and each person has a force field that's identified by their peculiar photograph, their particular photograph. Now, if I were to work with a collage of photographs of people, mm-hmm. provided some part of their skin is photographed, then I could, with one piece of paper on a collage, I could treat 20, 30, 40 people on a collage. I've been at this now for over 12 years with a public website. Today in my laboratory, I work with over 500,000 photographs of people. So we are gaining attention. Sometimes people will send me a collage of 400, 500 photographs. And when you, if you will, add all of that up over the past 12 years, today in my lab, I work with 500,000 photographs.
That's absolutely unbelievable. Wow. Well, I want to send you a photograph and have the experience myself. I'm open to all this kind of stuff. And I've had some experiences with certain people that have had, I don't know what you would call it, probably scalar energy or scalar light that have worked with me remotely, and I have had results. So, it sounds amazing, but when you're somebody that has that experience, you go, oh, okay, well, that really did happen. I had a woman who was a friend of our family who, I don't know what she called her work, but she said, I want you to lay down around 9 o'clock tonight. I just picked a time and I'm going to come and visit you. Mm. And I'm telling you, she did.
Yeah.
I got up and I was completely just so relaxed. And I mean, I could feel her energy doing whatever she was doing. And it was an amazing experience. Now, You know, to tell that to some people, they'd think I was crazy, or that I was, it was just, you know, wishful thinking, or it's not quote real, you know, but it was an experience that happened. So I know it was real. So I don't know if it's a similar thing, but she was a very, spiritually evolved person and really believed in, it sounds like what you're talking about, these connections that we have that are not physical.
Yes. Now that calls to mind, if you're just looking at the electromagnetic spectrum, you look at the physical human body, discounting this spiritual side. So what am I getting at? The scalar energy realm, the non-physical realm, calls to mind the spirit, or calls to mind some type of aura. Some people call that the aura. Well, there's two dimensions here. There is a physical realm, but there's also a spiritual realm. So I am not working with the biochemical reaction. I'm working with the informational system, which is the non-physical spirit energy. Imagine that. I am working with the essence of God, the spirit of God. That's what scalar energy is.
Well, I'm glad we got to that, because I was thinking that the entire time.
Yeah.
Now these instruments, mm-hmm. See, now you're going from this quantum idea to physical instruments mm-hmm. that do things. So how does that connection happen? And also, I want to know how you got started in this.
The instruments that I work with are scalar energy instruments. They're custom built.
Okay.
And there's two scientists that I give immediate credit to. Nikola Tesla, that I studied, and I can understand his work, at least in theory. And then I met with a family by the name of Hieronymus, and the Hieronymus family developed these instruments. Notably, the inventor is Galen Hieronymus. Mm-hmm. He was awarded actually a U.S. patent for a scalar energy instrument. It's been long forgotten. I have taken up the work of Galen Hieronymus, and I continue on with his work. So the original design is not mine. The inventor Galen Hieronymus, an American, developed scalar energy instruments, received a U.S. patent, but it has long since been forgotten, or at least in some respects suppressed. So this is indeed a valid science. Keep in mind, there's two opportunities. There's two dimensions. I don't work in this world of electricity and magnetism. I work in another dimension. And that's the very key here. You cannot explain my results by way of electricity and magnetism. It's not Newtonian science. There's two types of physics. There is Newtonian physics and scalar physics. They're both distinct. They both abide by different laws of nature.
I can see why people would be one, skeptical, and two, afraid, because it's a concept that it's even for me, who I think is a fairly open-minded person and does podcasts with, you know, people who are on cutting edge technologies and science. I'm still struggling with the idea. I mean, I want it to be the thing that you're saying it is. But I'm just telling you how my mind's doing. Like, oh, is this real? Is this can't be real. This is real. There's part of it that resonates with me. Another part of me from the way I grew up and the training and what the society is saying, this is not real. I'm saying real a lot, but it's my mind is really doing some strange little somersaults right now. I'm just being really honest with you because
I get it.
Yeah. So I'm going to send you a photograph. You know, I want to have the experience.
Yes.
So I'm going to go into it with an open mind mm-hmm. and also a critical mind at the same time. Not criticism, but.
I want you to. Yeah. It's never been done before. I'm the inventor. I don't expect people to have heard of this before. The protocol is unprecedented. I developed the protocol. It's groundbreaking research. So I have to present this to the world.
Well, how did you get started as a researcher in this field? What were you doing before? Because, I mean, you don't look like you're 25. You might be. Yeah.
I'm 63. By
yeah.
Then.
All right. Well, we're in the same arena. I'm 69. So the so you said 15 years ago. So you were like 40 something. And when you started, what were you doing before that?
I had to work for a living, but I always had the desire to develop. I always had the desire to do this. Now, I had the good fortune in 1993 to meet with this family, the Hieronymus family. And then I saw the practical application of this energy. You know, imagine, put yourself in my shoes. You see these functioning instruments that work with photographs, instruments that can look at a microbe through a photograph of a microbe and destroy or disassemble that microbe. For instance, a scalar energy instrument developed by Dr. Hieronymus could look at the molecular intelligence of Epstein-Barr virus and break down those molecular bonds of the Epstein-Barr virus. So with a photograph of a germ, a microbe, the instrument can look at the force field of Epstein-Barr and then reduce that, break it apart, or reduce it to chaos. That's the ability of a scalar energy instrument working through photographs.
Okay, now I'm going to ask you another question. That Epstein-Barr that you just showed me, that virus, you showed me a picture of that, or the cell. You showed me a picture of a cell. How does the scalar energy not destroy the entire cell, only creating chaos in the one that you know, the ones that are right. Experiencing Epstein-Barr? And how does that relate to the individual that has this, this condition?
So if I place this photograph of the virus inside the instrument would look for the virus by signature, and then it would download that signature into my photograph. Now, keep in mind, it's informational. We're only working with information.
Okay.
So the information of the Epstein-Barr virus is broadcast into my quantum plane. So information shares, it's quantum entanglement, so to speak. So if I had the Epstein-Barr virus in my force field, this photograph of Epstein-Barr would allow the identification of Epstein-Barr and the dismantling or the chaotic state of Epstein-Barr. A photograph of a microbe serves to identify the microbe in a person in their quantum field and eradicate it. And it happens instantaneously. It's not a chemical reaction. It's an informational. It's a knowing.
This explains in a more scientific way where how there is incidence of spontaneous healing with people and people that are able to hands-on healing type things. Yes. I mean, that's the kind of energy that's getting transferred.
Healing hands are scalar light hands. When somebody can place hands on you and you're healed, it's the information, it's God's light or the instruction from God that's healing you. So a person has the ability to broadcast scalar energy, as does my instrument, which can broadcast scalar energy. So the information from this instrument will seek out and destroy the Epstein-Barr virus, or the information from healing hands will seek out and destroy, likewise, the Epstein-Barr virus. So I've proven by way of instrumentation, spontaneous healing or healing hands, or some people, I consider my instrument to be similar to the Ark of the Covenant. The Ark of the Covenant gave off broadcast light, and in so doing, the Ark of the Covenant was a scalar energy vessel.
It's now I'm thinking, wouldn't it be amazing? And you're probably thinking the same thing. If everyone had something like this in their home at some point, where we are able to live with something that can change us instantaneously, or even if it was an hour, I wouldn't care. to be able to heal ourselves on a global level, it would change the entire planet. When you think about that, just on the physical level, but then what are the other implications in terms of, I know you mentioned addiction and what about, brain health, all those kinds of things, mental health issues.
So with this information system, this scalar light, I believe it's divine light, I don't think there's any limit. There's just, it's a matter of time before we understand how these instruments work and how we can use this energy and engineer this energy. So it has vast potential. I know of one researcher, his name was Grubenikoff. He used scalar energy to negate gravity. Scalar energy causes gravity. And he was able to levitate with an anti-gravity instrument. Why? Because he understood scalar energy to the point that he could negate a force field and create anti-gravity. So the future is bright with scalar energy. The future with scalar energy, scalar light, we are going to change the course of history.
Well, if everything you're saying is, I'm still, I'm trying to grasp. I wanna be able to really get this. A lot of it I do.
Yeah.
I just, I'm going to send you a photograph and I can't wait. I can't wait. I'm really excited about it.
Thank you.
Potential is unbelievable. I mean, it really is. And then I guess you could ask a question of, well, why isn't this already, why didn't the universe already give us this in the beginning? Why has there been so much human suffering when God's light that and the scalar light has this kind of power? What is the plan of the universe that has created so much distress and suffering with humanity? And, why now? What's going on? What do you think? I mean, it's obviously beyond our little pea brains, but we'll figure it out to the best we can.
It is a gift from God. And Tesla tried to give this to the world, but we were not ready for it. And frankly, he was suppressed. Now, the international bankers were against Tesla because they saw where free energy would go and it would destroy their monopolies. So now we have an opportunity with my invention, and let's see how the world embraces this.
Yeah. Well, no, that's I totally get that. My question is really, and it's an unanswerable question. That's why I'm asking it. I like these kinds of things. I like to really just sort of let my mind go into these places that are sort of unknowable in some ways. We have a universal intelligence, a God, whatever you want to call it, the force that animates us, whatever you want to call it, created the universe, our planet. Our planet has so much human suffering and difficulties and, war and diseases and, misguided types of belief systems that harm us. But and this scalar energy, which can mitigate almost all of that, why didn't that force start with this so we didn't have all this suffering? It's really that sort of ultimate spiritual question is why have we as human beings been given suffering or experiencing suffering? What is the purpose of that? I mean, I understand how struggle makes you feel stronger when you get through a struggle because I've had that experience. But man, there's some stuff that is just so difficult. I don't think anybody can answer that question, but I'd just be curious to see, you must have thought about this as somebody who thinks
there's a great deal of suffering in the world. And I see scalar light technology as a means to alleviate so much of that suffering. So we resonate there, Bob. I have to approach the people, form some type of grassroots following, keep away the evil influences of the world, and then bring this technology to the fore, bring this technology to the attention of many people. Our interview today is the best I can do. There's no money behind me.
No, I understand everything you're saying.
I'm saying this for the benefit of your audience. One researcher.
Yeah.
I'm one man. There's only so much I can do.
I'm just wondering, here's a thought I just had, that we were in the beginning part of what you're talking about. And for some reason, humans distance themselves from God. God does not forsake human beings, would be my answer to that. Mm-hmm. Is that, and I don't know why we've done that as human beings. it's this idea that this thing exists. We have this connection to it. And, you know, I don't know what it is about people that don't want, aren't able to, or haven't been shown, or are afraid to connect with that power, that life force, that energy. I don't know what that characteristic is in the human experience that has, you know, because a lot of suffering is really unnecessary.
Yes, you're right.
Yeah.
I see the what a travesty. I see the suffering in the world today. So much of it can be avoided.
I mean, that's really my whole purpose in doing this show, is really to get people on to talk about these possibilities from physical, mental, spiritual aspects. And people are doing amazing work. So, you know, it's really important to get this message out to as many people as possible, that
right.
Open your heart and your eyes and your soul to what the potential is out there, with so many people trying to do the types of things that you're doing. You know, not specifically this, but the same motivation, which is, yeah, it's really amazing. But your website, people can learn more, because, you know, for me, I want to know more about this. So let's say what your website is, so people can go there and learn more about what Tom is up to.
The website is scalarlight.com, S-C-A-L-A-R, light, L-I-G-H-T.com.
Okay.
We offer on the website, on the homepage, 15 days of free sessions. So if you take us up on that, you can send us your photograph, and family members with their permission, you can send us photographs of your pets. And then for 15 days, we will work with your chakras, balance your chakras, identify, eliminate pathogens, microbes. And we also have another program, a micronutrient program, in which we will assemble nutrients, micronutrients. That's a 15-day free experience, no credit card, no debit card required. This is the way we introduce this groundbreaking technology. We have to have a way, a simple, easy way to introduce this. So you simply email us your photograph. That's all. Just email us your photograph.
Oh, so it can be a digital photograph.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay. I was going to say, does it have to be a hard, photograph
just email
on paper?
And why? Because any photograph of a person carries their signature. Imagine that. A photograph carries your information. It's like your energetic fingerprint or your DNA. So I'm able to work with anybody in the world because I can capture their energy through the photograph. This is how I'm treating 500,000 people today, by way of photographs. Nobody comes to my laboratory. I receive photographs, and the photographs can be miniaturized, and that's fine.
Unbelievable.
It is. This is a technology that's like none other.
But you know what's interesting when you talk about a photograph? Have you ever looked, and I'm sure you have, I have, you look at a photograph and you get a feeling about the person.
Mm-hmm.
It's not just, oh, he's smiling, he's happy, she's frowning, she's angry. It's not that. It's something else. It's like, I'm feeling how they're feeling, almost, you know. It's like that connection that we have sometimes to people. And so I've had that with photographs. We go, oh, that person's really, you know, sad. I can really, and it's not just the nonverbal communication. I mean, it is nonverbal, but it isn't just like I'm picking up on facial expressions or body language, which is always a part of it. And it's kind of hard to separate, but there's another thing that's going on, which is, I think, what we're talking about.
Yes. Now, many people who are are spiritually advanced, or they'll have an appreciation for the divine, this will start to resonate with them, because now we have some type of science, scalar science, that proves the spiritual dimension. Again, all of my work is non-physical. I just work by energy signatures, signatures of people, okay, that are found on a piece of paper, on a photograph. Well, this is the new science. This is scalar energy science. And once we develop this quantum healing technique and people resonate with it, then I want to move on. I want to develop anti-gravity instruments. I want to move on. I want to be able to illuminate a house, a home, with scalar energy. Now, that will be wireless energy from the sun and the stars. There is no infrastructure. When I work with my instrument, I don't rely upon satellites, cell phone towers, electrical wiring, any type of substation. I simply place a person's photograph in the instrument. So there is no infrastructure needed. The infrastructure exists. Now imagine, if you're looking at our current energy system, you need wind farms, you need nuclear reactors, you need telephone poles and telephone wire, so to speak. You need substations, you need coal, you need oil, you need gas, you need refineries, on and on and on. Scalar energy, the infrastructure already exists.
You give me a simplified version of this instrument. What's in there? What's it made out of? How does it do what it does? I mean, I'm not a science guy. I'm interested in it, but I haven't studied it.
The instrument creates and maintains a scalar wave. That's it. If an electrical instrument creates or maintains an electrical charge, some type of movement of electrons, remember, scalar energy is non-physical. This is not a movement of electrons. We simply create a double helix, which is a scalar wave. That's what we're able to do.
I'm going to ask you, it might seem silly. Does the instrument get plugged into electricity to work?
Initially, yes, because I can take an electrical current and convert it into a scalar wave.
Okay.
Once I do that, I can amplify the energy a millionfold. And I'll prove that because I can work with a million people at a time. So how is it that one instrument can broadcast this energy through the infrastructure that pre-exists? The atmosphere, the universe is the infrastructure. And I could work with 1 million, 2 million people instantaneously, simultaneously.
Like I'm saying, this is very, very hard for me to grasp completely and trust, but I think the audience will appreciate a little bit of my desire to have it be what you're saying it is, and my let's just say it's a healthy skepticism, but I'm skeptical and I'm not skeptical. I'm really sort of teetering here, and I want to have this experience is what I'm saying.
And you should, and that's how we prove it to people. Now keep in mind, and I'm in no way am I offended, experience the 15-day free session. This has never been done before. I do not have any peers. Nobody is working side by side me. How do I prove this? I have to prove it by example. Sign up for the 15-day free session. That's how we prove it. Easy enough, right?
Yeah, and the price is right too. Now you said we. Do you have some help at all?
We have a small staff.
Yeah, because that just to communicate.
Yeah, we have a staff that will answer your question. If you have questions, you write us or call us. We'll answer your questions. But as far as research, I'm the only researcher.
Okay.
And why? Well, not many people want to devote their life to a science that has not yet been embraced.
I get that.
There's no job prospect here, Bob. You know, if you have proficiency in scalar energy, great. You can't market yourself. There's no paycheck, Bob.
Well, I guess the paycheck would be inner peace, joy, the knowledge that you're helping someone. There really is no bigger paycheck. It's just not cash.
And that's what keeps me going. I want to see the world improve. So, you know, in the spirit of Nikola Tesla, this great scientist who gave his life to the betterment of humanity, You know, we owe it to him to finally introduce radiant energy. He called it radiant energy to mankind. And that's another good indication that he was no longer working with electricity, Bob. Yeah. Earlier in his life, he would call it electromotive force or AC electricity. Later in his life, he was using the term radiant energy, which was not electricity. So what is radiant energy? It's the new science he discovered, which was scalar energy.
And all this is tying in with, you know, quantum physics very neatly and perfectly. It's, you know, the two things, science and the spiritual, are coming together. Well, they're already together, but they're coming together in the zeitgeist. Let's use that word. Tom, thank you so much for talking to me today. I'm so looking forward to doing some scalar light.
Thank you.
What happens? It's really very profound. I'm gonna have to take a long walk after this.
It is profound. It's unlike anything you've ever been introduced to before, because it's a new science. So there's no shame. I had to learn this 30 years ago, and now the world has to learn this. It's a path. It'll take time.
You will. Sure. Anything that's shakes it up is going to take time. Yeah. There'll be resistance, but that's okay.
Yeah.
That's how you know something is valid. If you got to have some resistance, I think, to anything new to validate it.
When the audience visits my website, scalarlight.com, read the 4,000 testimonies on the website. And that should give you an indication as to the validity of quantum healing.
Well, thank you. You have a blessed day, and congrats for all the wonderful work. I love the dedication and the mission.
Thank you.
Much appreciation for you folks listening to The Exploding Human. The website is theexplodinghuman.com. The YouTube channel is The Exploding Human with Bob Nickman. I want to thank Tom Paladino one more time for a fascinating interview. You guys have a fantastic day. Thank you.